Raymarching is great in terms of what it can render, but the problem with it is that it's incredibly inefficient. The per pixel calculation allows for a lot of redundancies, since many close pixels would probably march the same distance before actually diverging in their calculation. This is where the big brother of Raymarching comes along, Conemarching. There aren't a lot of resources for Conemarching, only mentioned in a PDF and a few articles online. But the general idea is that instead of marching one pixel at a time, you could march multiple pixels, which mathematically is represented as a cone, and then march per pixel once you've reached a good point. This can be done on multiple passes on the GPU that eventually result in more efficient rendering time. Implementing Conemarching will require its own video, which I'll do in the future. But for now, you can clearly see the stark difference in performance with the FPS gain. In this test, I'm using the same SDF, but one is rendered with Raymarching while the other is rendered with Conemarching. This will now give me the chance to experiment with more complex fractals without worrying about performance. Once I had the Conemarching done, I experimented with coloring the fractals by using a method called orbit trapping. The basic idea is to select a specific color to render based on the number of iterations that have occurred in the SDF. It requires a bit of tweaking, but at the end, I was able to get something that resembles green hills. Moreover, I implemented two different visual effects, the first one being a fairly light FXAA. On close inspection, the effect isn't the best anti-aliasing, but it's cheap and does the job well enough. The second effect is a simple depth blur. This is done by applying a Gaussian filter on the entire screen and then multiplying that effect by the depth value. In other words, making the render more blurry the farther the terrain is. This is not exactly how depth of field works, but it is able to create a cinematic effect that is relatively cheap as well. Finally, I was able to apply dynamic shadows between polygonal geometry and Raymarch geometry. This was easier than I expected, since all I had to do is shadow map the polygonal geometry onto the fractal terrain. It required a bit of math to get the perspective right, but at the end, I was able to connect both the Raymarch geometry and the polygonal geometry and have them interact with one another dynamically. The player controller from before was pretty stiff. The camera was directly following the player without any sway or motion, so I started to lerp the camera instead of just teleporting it. Moreover, I made the lerp for the transformation of the camera to be different from the lerp of its rotation, which resulted in a quite dynamic camera. This, alongside the new character model, made the movement of the player more lively and vivid. And finally, and what really pushed the game to new grounds, is the addition of a speed boost. This made the game 10 times more fun and action-based. It also made the game more challenging, since the player might be able to get more points the faster they are, but they have less control of their steering. In other words, high risk, high reward. Adding all of this work together, I was able to make the following demo. That's all for this devlog. As expected, all the resources relating to cone marching will be down below. And since there's no tutorial about cone marching on YouTube, I might end up making one. The process is lengthy, but it's worthwhile in terms of the performance gain. Thank you for watching, and until next time. Bye-bye.